I'm not afraid. to you guys. Those of you that were here last night, but he's a good friend that when I came to Malaysia, I met with him, and he got a big church in Malaysia, very big building. And he's the superintendent of the of Tabernacle of Worship. And he's the chairman and the principal of Malaysia Bible College. And he's the superintendent of the Malaysia
Assemblies of God Southern District.
Yeah, district, Malaysian district, Southern District. And we are so glad to be here today. And welcome him to come and share with us like what happened last night. We believe that God gave him the message, the word to give to us like what happened last night. I am blessed last night. I am blessed last night.
Amen.
And I look forward for the Lord to use him in a mighty way. Let's give a hand to the Lord. Reverend Christopher.
Thank you.
Good morning to all of you. You know, today I want to talk about, yesterday we talked about facing our giants. Today I
want to
talk about taking Goliath down. Today I want to talk about taking Goliath down.
Amen.
You know, it's easy to face, it's difficult to take him down. You know, I want to take the scripture text from 2 Samuel chapter 21, verses 15 to 17.
All right,
2 Samuel 21, verses 15 to 22. Amen. Maybe I get my brother to read, or I just read. Okay? 2 Samuel 21, verses 15 to 22.
Besta animal be fare for folan, peko ai foki. Hatau akau Filistian ki isleri, pe aluhi fo te vita fkata mo ene kau tama yo eki, one ta ya kau Filistian, pe ngosi ai ate vita. Peko Isipi Benopi, Kotaha or Fanao, I Sayaniti, Ayako, Mamafa or Honotao, Kosikerika Pantolungao, Begone Aite for all on a loud and a tatia tevita. Veseta Hafitu Kaka Alfia, Apisai, Tamaseluvaya, and a tatia Fristia Tamatei. Tokfuankawa, Kiai, I Lahio tevita opehe e ikai te ketoe alu moki mautolu ki he tau na amate ae mama o isileri.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You know, the Bible is full of principles and facts which we can use in our life to face our giant and to bring them down.
O mawi ngā mino ke tau lame I koe tohi tampu o kfonua ia ngāhi mo oni mo whakahino hino I fonga koe ke tau hākia ki ho tau ngāhi sayaniti ke fohi fohi kere kere.
Like we said last night that the devil and his army are constantly coming against us as Christians, as pastors, as leaders of the local churches.
Hange koe tau lame koe ane po, koe whiri pa mo ene mata tau Ognau, fai he taimi ki he taimi, ahono whakawhi ātungia oe mōi a karistiane me he fai whi kau ki he sitaha.
If the devil is given even half a chance,
ka bau e oange hakonga oe whainga maria ki he putu I te wolo koe ni.
He will turn your day, your week, your month into the valley of Ella.
Tene hanga e ia o furihi ke hei aho mōi o au ki he futoa wha mamate.
He will turn you and I.
Tene hanga ufanga fukatapu o halu ki tau dolu.
He will boo you and I.
Tene hanga eia o fukasilongo ki tau dolu.
He will tease you and I.
Tene hanga o fukamatariri I ki tau dolu.
He will echo into our ears day in, day out that we cannot, we have problem, we have difficulty, we are failure, we are victims.
Tene fana I ho tau teringa, kia ki tau dolu kai kakai, fau I ki tau dolu he kai ke tau lama ke I kuna he fono au tau
fai. And life sometimes seems to be like, a hill, a high hill that we have to climb. You know, in the world today that we live, Goliath is still, giant is still very much alive. Giants can be in the area of debts, in the area of disasters, in the area of sicknesses and diseases, in the area of danger, in the area of pain and hurt. There will be different kinds of sizes of challenges that come in our life every day. When one comes and go down and we defeat, another one is waiting to come. And the devil's purpose is to, first of all, remove the peace from our mind. Steal the joy from our heart. Rob us of the victory that God has prepared for us. Do you know that David know about the enemy? And I want to bring you to the story where David picked up 5 stones. I'm not going to use the stones as symbolical, neither as it as analogical. I want to use the 5 stones as 5 major decisions that David made in his life when he faced Goliath. So what are the 5 decisions that David made that you and I need to learn to make in our life every day? What are these 5 stones or 5 decisions that we need to learn to make every day in our lives? When we see our enemy, when we face our enemy, how can we bring them down? How can we bring them down? The first stone. The stone of the past. David's, Goliath's size and strength jumped David's memory back to the past. While everyone was afraid, while everyone went into hiding, David remember. You know, many of us, when we face our giants, when we face our sickness, when we face our problem, when we face our difficulties, when we face our challenges in life, we lose our mind. We lost our memory. Memory of what? Memory of the goodness of God. Memory of the faithfulness of God. Memory of the power of God. Memory of the ability of God. When Goliath appeared, when David stand and face Goliath, he remembered. He remembered. Amen. Don't let problems, don't let sicknesses, don't let things that happen around you and I cause you and I to forget about God. We don't need to see God. We need to remember what God has done for us last year, last month, last week. Oh, if you forget about the goodness of God, if you forget about all that God has done for you. You and I will find no hope in chasing and facing and confronting the giants of our lives. You know, David remembered that God has given him strength to wrestle a giant, a lion. David remember that God strengthened his arm to tear the bear's part. And because of his memory of what God has done, when he looked at Goliath, he said, I will do the same with you because my God is a powerful God. Amen. Look at 1 Samuel 17. Verses 34 to 36. But David said to Saul, your servant has been keeping his father's sheep when a lion and a bear came and carried off a sheep from the flock. David said, I went after it. I struck it down. I rescued the sheep from his mouth. When they turned against me, I seized them by the hair. I struck it down. And I killed it. Your servant has killed both the lions and the bear. This uncircumcised Philistine will be like one of them because he has come to defy the name of God. Amen. Now listen to this. A good memory makes heroes. A bad memories make victims. If you have good memory, good testimony, you remember what God has done for you in the past, every Goliath that comes, that's just another thing that God can help you to overcome. If you have bad memories, what is one of the things that the devil can do to you? He put fear into your life and my life. He says to you, the mountain is too big. The giant is too large. The challenges is too great. Your finances is too bad. Your health is hopeless. Your relationship is gone. Your pain is too great. Your hurt is so deep. No way you can forgive. No way you can move on. You know why he do that? It's to put fear into your life. If fear comes into our life, if a fear will darken our memory about the past, what God has done for us. Are you with me? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So therefore we must have good memory of what God has done. Listen to here. Catalog the good successes of God in your life.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You know, in 1 Chronicles chapter 16 and verse 12, the Bible said this. It said, remember. Remember. Remember his marvelous works which he has done and his wonders. Keep a record of what God has done for you in your life, in your memory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When I finish the message, I want to share with you something about God. Someone says this. Write today's worries in sand. Chisels yesterday's victory in stone.
But pick up
the stone of the past every day in your life to remind you of the goodness of God. Amen. Amen. That's what we need to do. For you.
Thank you.
Number two. The stone of prayer. The first decision is this. You have to decide to remember the goodness of God in the past. The second decision you need to make is the decision to pray when you face an obstacles, when you face challenges in your life. Many people, when they face opposition, when they face sicknesses and diseases, when they face failures and challenges in their life and problems in their life, you know what they do? They run away from the church. They don't come to church. When the pastor calls them and look for them, they don't want to see the pastor. They hide from people, they hide from God. You know what David did? When he faced problem, he comes to God in prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Don't keep everything to yourself. Share what you go through, what you face in life with God. Amen.
Amen.
You know what happened? Before David go high, he went low. He went on his knee before God. How many of you know, before we can fight the giant in our life, we need to go low before God and say, God, I can't do it. I can't face my enemy without you, without your strength, without your power. Before David ascending to fight the giant in his life, David descended in prayer to depend on God, to prepare himself to face the giant.
Amen.
Every time before you face an enemy, go before God to face God. As you go low and say, God, I need you. I need your strength. I need your power. Amen.
Amen.
You know what the Apostle Paul says? He says in Ephesians 6 and verse 18. He says, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayer and requests. Then he said this. With this in your mind, be alert. Always keep on praying for the Lord's people in all times. Amen.
Amen.
Do you know prayer spawned David's successes? Amen. When he did not know what to do, he went to God. Don't run here, don't run there. Run to God. Amen.
Amen.
Run to God. Bring your needs to God. Trust in the Lord. And the Bible tells us in 1 Samuel 30 and verse 6.
1
Samuel 30 and verse 6. He said this, when the people of Israel were thinking of stoning David because their family, their houses were all taken away and burned down. David found strength in the Lord. David found strength in the Lord. When all the generals and all the leaders and all the captains of the army of Israel were angry and discouraged, David did not get discouraged. David did not get angry. David went and waited upon the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And you know what happened? God strengthened him. God strengthened him. Amen.
Amen.
You know, when Saul's soldiers tried to capture David, David turned towards God. And you know what happened? In Psalms 59 and verse
16.
Psalms 59 and verse 16, David said this. He said, God, you are my defense. You are my refuge in days of troubles. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do you know why David pray? Do you know why David come before God when Do you know why he came to the Lord in prayer when he faced problems? Do you know why when Goliath comes, when giant comes into his life, when challenges come in his life, do you know why he went low to pray? Oh, let me read to you in Psalms 57 verses 1 and 2. Psalms 57 verses 1 to 2. In the Message Bible, it says this. It says this, be good to me, God. And now I run to you for dear life. He says, I'm hiding under your wings until the hurricanes of life blows over. I call up to the high God, the God who holds me together. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do you know when challenges come, it tears us apart, tears us apart, tears us apart. But when we come before God, He holds us together. Hallelujah. He strengthens us. Amen.
Amen.
When David was soaked in the Lord, when David's mind was soaked in the Lord in prayer, he stood strong. He stood powerful. Amen.
Amen.
So, peace is promised to those who fixes his mind on God. You know why? Because when you seek the Prince of Peace, you have the peace of God.
Amen.
Amen. You know why we don't have peace? You know why we don't have peace?
Because
we never seek the Prince of God.
We
never seek the Prince of Peace.
Because
we look at people, we look at problem too much.
We need to
look at God.
Amen.
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 Amen. Number
three.
The stone of priority.
The
stone of priority.
You
know, when giant comes into our life, we need to remember the stones of priority.
That
is our highest priority as Christians, as pastors, as leaders, as a church. Many times we never thought of this. It is God's reputation. David jealously guarded the reputation of God. He says, I'm not going to let the giant, I'm not going to let Goliath, I'm not going to let the challenges of life, I'm not going to let problem to come and defame the reputation of God. He guarded the reputation of God. You know why David guarded the reputation of God? You know why David fought for the reputation of God? Because in 1 Samuel 17 verses 46 and 47, he said this, that the whole world will know there is a God in Israel. And then he said, for there the battle is the Lord's. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, when giant came, David saw Goliath as a chance to show off how powerful, how good, how faithful our God is.
Hallelujah.
Now the question is this. Did David know he would exit the battle alive? Did David know that he will leave the battle alive?
No.
But he was willing to give his life for the reputation of God. He was willing to give his life for the reputation of God. In 1 Samuel 17, verses 23 to 25, the Bible says, as he was talking with them, Goliath, the Philistine champion of Gath, stepped out from his line and shouted his usual defiance, and David heard it.
Verse 24
says, whenever the Israelites saw the man Goliath, they all fled from him in great fear. And verse 25 says, and now the Israel had been saying, do you see how this man keeps coming up? He comes out to defy Israel. The king will give great wealth to the man who kills him. You know, everybody, even you have money, even you have the daughter of King Saul, they were all afraid. But David says, I will not allow the giant to defy the name of God. The Bible says, when he faced the giant, it may be the giant of cancer or diseases. Do you know cancer and diseases and dialysis and all these sicknesses of the body is a chance for God to show who
Hallelujah.
He is? Amen. He is a healer. Your sin and my sin is God's opportunity to show forth His grace and His mercy. Your struggle and my struggle with marriages and family problems and family issues and hurts and pain is an opportunity for God to advertise His power and His love. You must see your struggle as God's canvas. Where He will paint His goodness, where He will paint His greatness, where He will paint His mercy, where He will paint His grace, where He will paint His power, where He will paint His power upon our lives. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Number four. The stone of passion. We must make a decision to be passionate about God, about our lives in Him.
First Samuel 17:48
says, as the Philistine moved closer to attack him, David ran quickly toward the battle line to meet him. David ran not from the giant. David ran towards the giant.
There
King Saul and his enemy ran from the enemy. King Saul and all his generals and David's brother, they all ran from the giant. Do you know when David ran towards the enemy? Do you know nobody put a bet on him and said David will win? Hello? Huh?
Hello?
Right or not? When we face financial situation, when we face problems in our life, when we face difficulties in our life, you know what? Everybody will look at us and say, you know what? You are doomed. You're going to lose. You will not rise. Even his own brothers will think, this is crazy, you will not win. David knew. It is not him. It's going to be God. Amen.
Hallelujah.
David knew. It is not going to be his strength. It's not going to be his wisdom. It's not going to be his ability. It's not going to be his experience. David knew it is God. Amen. He
believed.
He said it's going to be God that's going to work a miracle in my situation. He has nothing to do with me. It's all to do with God. And David said, my part is to trust in God, is to believe in God, is to rely on God, and to believe that with God all things are possible. Amen.
Amen.
You must believe. You must believe. You know, church, we go through life day in, day out, we hurt and pain and sicknesses and diseases and problems. Few days before I came, I was not well. I was sick. I can't speak. When I breathe, I can hear my chest got sound. I say, God, I'm going to Auckland to preach for Pastor Bishop Supele. I
said,
I don't know how I'm going to preach if I'm not well. But I said, I'm going to depend on you. I don't know how. I don't know how you're
going to
heal me. I just trust in you. Amen.
Amen.
And when I came, I saw God not only help me, he healed me, he empowered me.
Amen.
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 You must be passionate about your God. You must be passionate about your life in God. Amen. Don't think your life lightly. But think your life seriously. Think your life passionately. Amen. That if God is for us, who can be against us? Hallelujah. Lastly, the stone of persistency. The stones of persistence. David made a decision to be persistent. David didn't think for once one rock is good enough. Why? Because David knew Goliath had four huge, monstrous relatives. It's not just one Goliath. There are four others relatives. Do you know that? You don't know. You don't believe me. Let's look at the Bible. 2 Samuel 21 verse 16. Ibsbi Benot. I think you better turn to it. One of the sons of
Rapha
had a bronze spearhead weighing about 7.5 pounds. And he had a new sword and he planned to kill David. How do we know that Ibsbi Benot is about 9 feet tall and big size? Amen.
Amen.
You know there's another giant as well? 2 Samuel 21, verse 18. Later at Gop. There was another battle with the Philistine. Sibia Kaya, the Hishabite killed Sep.
Ko Sepa Kaya, ko Totaha Husa, Nanehanga, Otamate Asapa.
And when the sons of Rapha,
by the time he foha o Rapha,
he is also 9 feet tall.
Futehiva, Polyhiva.
And then in verse 19.
During
another battle of Gob, Elhanah, son of Ziah from Bethlehem, killed the brother Lahim of Goliath of Gath.
Wow.
3 already. One more. This is bigger. In verse 20, at Gath, another battle took place. A huge man was there. He had 6 fingers on each hands. He had 6 toes on each foot. 24 fingers, 24 toes all in. And this man was one of the sons of Rapha. Wow.
Wow.
Not one Goliath. There are 4 more giants. Why? Have you ever thought why 5 stones? One, you see, in our life, that is more than one giant. Every time when you defeat one giant, another one will come. Every time when you fail one giant, another one will come. Every time when one problem comes, one sickness comes, one disease comes, one hurt comes, one failure comes, another one will come, another one will come, another one will come. In all that David knew, he's not going to run away. He's not going to run away. Amen.
Amen.
How many of you know every problem, every struggle we face, another one that comes is bigger, stronger, more difficult? Amen.
Amen.
David never give up. David never let down his laurels. He said, I have to be careful. I have to remember the goodness of God. I have to remember who my God is. I have to remember who I am in God. When one come, I will punch him down. Another come, I will punch him down. Another come, I will punch him down. I will not stop punching him. Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes as Christians, we are so ignorant. We thought we have finished killing one, we are okay. Everything is good. You know, the devil. If today he fell, tomorrow he will come. If tomorrow he fell, next week he will come. If he fell next week, next month he will come again. Hello?
Hello?
Yeah. He will come again. But for us, when he comes again, we depend on the Lord and we punch him down again.
Amen.
We Amen. Will punch him down again and punch him down again and punch him down
again.
Amen.
Amen.
That's why the Bible says it's not how well we start the race, it's how well we finish the race. Amen. Amen. We have to learn to pick the devil, the Goliath down. How? We have to remember the past, what God has done. We have to be prayerful. We have to be prayerful. Amen. We have to fix our eyes on the priority that God's reputation has to be kept. You know, every time you don't keep the reputation of God, you know what the devil will do? He'll come to God and say, huh, you think Christopher, man, he win this time? Huh? Strip him of all his wealth, cause sicknesses and diseases come to him, he will forsake you. Right? Isn't that what the devil said to Job?
Yeah.
He said to God,
yeah.
He said to God, you know what God said? Huh, go ahead. He is a giant slayer. Right or not?
Hallelujah.
Even his wife told him, curse God and die. What did Job say? Silly woman. Silly woman. Do we only expect the good from God? What did Job say? Naked I come, naked I go. Yet the name of the Lord still need to be praised. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. I finish. But let me share with you this. Do you know why we can be a giant slayer? You know why? We all, whether we are members, we are leaders, we are pastors, whether we are a church, you know why the church can be a giant slayer?
Because
can I ask every one of you to open your Bible? To Matthew 19. And verse 26. Matthew 19 and verse 26. You got it? Matthew 19 verse 26. It says this. Everybody read together. Count three. Two and three. Jesus looked at them intently and said, humanly speaking, it is impossible. But with God, everything is possible. With God, everything is possible. Amen.
Amen.
One more verse I want you to look at. Musicians, will you come? Mark
9:23.
Everybody turn to Mark.
Mark 9:23.
Everybody got it? Mark 9:23. What it says, it said this, with the man who believe, all things are possible. Believe who? Believe in yourself? Believe in your pastor? Believe in your leaders? Believe in your church? No. Believe in Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
You see, church, it's one thing to know that with God all things is possible. It's another thing for us in reality to really say, God, you know what? I may not understand. I may not be able to comprehend. But I believe. But I trust. But I have faith. In my car. My mind may not be able to understand. My mind may not be able to comprehend. But I know my God, with Him, all things are possible. Amen.
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 You know, many years ago, when my son is now 26 years old. Many years ago, when my son was 3.5 years old. His appendix burst for 4 days. When he took him to see the doctor, the doctor says nothing wrong with him. Then we took him for a holiday, and my daughter as well. When we reached the place where we are supposed to have our holidays, he still ran around. But if it comes to the night, he couldn't eat, he couldn't sleep, he was in pain throughout the whole night. We came back from the hospital. He said, Dad, I want to go home. I said, Jared, we just arrived. He said, I want to go home. When the morning came, we checked out and we went home. When we reached home, we took him to see the doctor who is from our church. They did the urine test, they did the blood test, there's nothing wrong with him. So he said, observe him for a few days. We took him home. But we knew that he was not well. Every night he was in pain. One day, 2 days, 3 days. We prayed for him. You know what? We took him back to the doctor. The doctor checked him. He said, you know what? Pastor, your son is very sick. And he's dying. Then we asked why? His appendix has burst for 4 days. We rushed him to the hospital. And the doctor checked him, operated on him, removed the broken and burst appendix, clean up inside, stitch him back, then came out from the surgery. The doctor told the church board members, told my sister-in-law, You must tell Pastor. You must tell Pastor Marian. Jared may not survive. Be prepared. Why? Because the toxic toxin from the burst appendix has gone into his whole body system.
He
has gone into all his brain, all his organs, and it went into his brain. And the doctor who operated on him said, even if Jared survived, he will be a vegetable. He will just lie on the bed and not able to move and talk and recognize. We in the ICU. We pray for him. We say, God, you gave us a son. We do not know why these things happened. It is a giant that came. We took turn to take care of him in the ICU. We prayed for him. And together we say, God, if it's your will, heal my son 100%. Even when the doctor said it's impossible, but it's not your will to heal him, take him home. Because we won't be able to take care of a son who's a vegetable. We said to the Lord, you are a good God. There are a lot of things in life we may never understand. God is not asking you and I to understand. God is asking you and I to dare to believe him. To trust him. You know what? When I learn to release to God, when I learn to depend on God, God came true. He worked a miracle. He worked a miracle. When my son came out from the hospital 1 month later, you know what happened? One day we were in our living hall and we were sitting down there talking. He told the mother. He said, Mom, on the first night after my surgery, I was lying on the bed. Mom, you were lying on this side of the bed and auntie was lying on this side of the bed. He said, Jesus came down from heaven. He said, Jesus came and Jesus put his hand on my heart. He said, Jared, I will heal you and you can go home. You know, church, for all parents in time of facing a giant like that, we get nervous, we get fearful, we get angry with God. But we say to ourselves this one thing. My God is still a good God. I may not never be able to understand the goodness of God, but God is still a good God. When I learned to trust God, God took my son and worked a miracle. All the doctor says is impossible. Even the surgeon says it cannot be healed. But the Bible says in Matthew 19:26, humanly speaking, it is impossible. But Jesus said, be God, all things are possible. And then he says again in Mark chapter 9, verse 23, if you believe.
If you
trust in me, if you release to me, I will show you who I am. Amen. The giants in our life will come again, again, and again, and again, and again, and again. You and I need to learn to say, you know what? My God is still good. Yesterday, today, and forever, He is still good. He is still good. He is still faithful. He is still
powerful.
Come on, let's stand together, shall we? I want you to declare just the mention of His name, the beautiful name of Jesus. How many of you know Jesus' name is a beautiful name? I want to call upon Him. I want to trust in Him. I want to believe in Him. I want to receive a miracle for my life. For my family. For my church. Amen. Amen. Come on, as we sing this song, would you just worship God?
Oh, and may the light, the light of Christ shine upon them. And through them, to touch this nation, Lord Jesus. To touch all the Tongans in New Zealand and in Tonga, Lord Jesus.
Aku itu sila dalam koma.